Let's discuss about transformer. In my previous video, we have discussed about sequence-to-sequence model. In sequence-to-sequence model, we convert sequence that are in one domain to the sequence in another domain, for example language translation. Like sequence-to-sequence model, transformer has encoder and decoder, and also used to solve sequence-to-sequence tasks. One disadvantage of sequence-to-sequence model is that, it doesn't handle long-range dependencies with ease. This is why transformer comes into the picture. Transformer handle long-range dependencies with ease. Transformer is also used to solve several complex tasks like sequence-to-sequence model, for example language translation and text summarization. Most important point to remember is that, transformer do not require sequential data to be processed in order. And due to this reason, transformer allows much more parallelization than regular RNN, and therefore reduced training times. In sequence-to-sequence model, the RNN network can be LSTM or GRU. But in transformer, we don't have any type of RNN. So, transformer doesn't include LSTM or GRU network. Look at this architecture. Don't get worried by looking this architecture. I will explain this step by step. First, let me discuss about input and output embedding. Can you see below architecture? If you turn on the subtitle, I guess it is difficult to see. So let me place this little bit upside. First, we have input and targeted output. Let me cover this together. If we are doing language translation from English to any other language like Hindi, our input will be the English language and targeted output will be the Hindi language. We have to provide both input and targeted output because we want our model to get learned. So, we pass English sentence to encoder block as input and translated Hindi sentence to decoder block as targeted output. Then we have to convert our strings to some numbers or matrix or vectors, as computer do not understand our language or words. For this purpose, words embedding technique can be used. Similar words are close to each other in this embedding space. To convert words to vector, mostly glove is used, which is pre-trained word representation technique. Using this technique or embedding space, each word gets converted into their corresponding vectors. Then these vectors get passed to the positional encoder. Each word may represent different meaning. Suppose in these two sentences, type has different meaning. Positional encoder helps in obtaining context of the word in sentence. We calculate positional encoder using this formula. Here, T is position of each word in sentence. Now the result from word embedding and positional encoder are added and passed further. That is, passed in this encoder. This encoder has two main parts. That is, multi-head attention and feed-forward network. What is attention? Attention simply refers to highlighting specific features of input. Right now, I am highlighting specific part of the screen so that you can focus on this part only. This is what attention network means. But what is inside this multi-head attention network? This V, K, Q are abstract vectors that extract different components of an input words. We have V, K, Q for every single word. Using these vectors, we calculate attention vector Z using this formula. This attention vector indicates how related each word vector is, with respect to each other. In this example, we clearly see how relevant is a word in English sentence to other words in the same sentence. But for every word it weighs, its value will be higher with itself in the sentence. We want to measure the interaction of each word with other words in that sentence, right? So what we do is, we determine multiple attention vectors per words. And then we take an average of that vectors which will be our final attention vector. Thus, we are using multiple attention vector, so we call it multi-head attention. This feed-forward layer is nothing but simply passing vectors in feed-forward neural network. This layer converts our attention vectors to a form that can be passed to next encoder or decoder layer. In each of this network, we have normalization. Normalization provides uniform scale for numerical values. Here, we can use batch normalization or layer normalization. In batch normalization, input values of the same neuron from different samples in one mini batch are normalized. As its name suggests, we apply batch normalization in batches, not on single input. Whereas in layer normalization, input values for different neuron in the same layer are normalized without consideration of mini batch. We have formula to calculate normalization. And in this formula, we have different mean value for each of batch and layer normalization. Next, we have decoder. In this decoder, embedding vector plus vector after positional encoding of targeted output will get passed and processed. These two layers are same as encoder. In decoder, we have extra masked multi-head attention. What does this masked multi-head refer to? Masked attention block doesn't compute attention vector for all words in a sentence. It only computes attention vector for current and prior words. It is because we want our network to get learn. And if it already knows the next word, there is no sense for learning to take place, right? We want it to predict next word using previous word. Then only we can compare predicted word with actual word and then update its matrix value. This way it will learn after several iterations. So we only calculate attention vectors for current and prior words. Thus, we have masked input in decoder. Next, we have multi-head attention. The result from encoder block are coming to this layer. So we call it encoder-decoder attention block. Now, the output from this block passed to feed-forward layer which converts vector to the form that are acceptable by another decoder or linear layer. This linear layer is also another feed-forward connection network. This linear network is used to expand the dimension into the number of words that are in targeted output. And this softmax function map the output based on a probability. This way, our model gets trained. Suppose if we are doing language translation from English to any other language like Hindi. This encoder takes all words simultaneously and produces meaningful embedding of all words simultaneously. If two words are similar, the number in vector will be close to each other. And in this decoder, output from encoder and translated Hindi language comes in. And it tries to generate next word from previous word one at a time, until the end of that sentence is reached. In summary, we have input and targeted output. We covered our string to some vectors or matrix representation, which is then passed to the positional encoder. And then the result from these two passes further. The task of encoder is to encode and process the input. Remember, multi-head attention is used to calculate how relevant is a word to other words in the same sentence. And this multi-head attention produces the attention vectors. This attention vectors are then passed into the feed-forward neural network. The task of feed-forward network is to transform the attention vectors into a form that is acceptable by the next encoder or decoder layer. In this decoder, two layers are same as encoder. We have extra masked multi-head attention layer which only calculate attention vectors for current and prior words. If we calculate attention vectors for all words, there will be no any learning. Finally, after passing to linear and softmax layer, it will decode the output. In this way, transformer works. I know it might be difficult for you. But watch this video repeatedly, you will get all. You can do research by yourself and also you can ask me in the comment section. This much for this video. I hope, this video helps you a lot. If you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe my channel IG Tech Team. I will meet you soon. Stay safe and keep learning.